world and welcome to a brand new Azure vlog. I hope you're doing well. I'm doing fine. So today I would like to talk about a topic that goes close to my heart again, Copilot for Security. In my previous video, I showed you how you could set up Copilot for Security and how you can use it in the standalone experience. Which means you had a ChatGPT-like interface where you could do prompts and Copilot was able to respond back to you with intelligent answers, of course. In this video, I would like to show you how Copilot for Security behaves itself in the Microsoft XDR portal, security.microsoft.com. And Microsoft calls that the embedded experience, and I think that's amazing. I'm going to show you how Copilot for Security can help you with resolving cybersecurity incidents. I'm also going to show you how you could use Copilot for Security in the advanced hunting experience of the Microsoft XDR portal. So without further ado, let's dive into the security portal and I'll show you around. Okay, so here we are in the Microsoft security portal. Nothing special to see here at the home screen, at least in my case. If this is the first time you are going to the Defender portal and you have Copilot for Security enabled, it will give you a brief explanation on how you can use Copilot for Security in this experience. So let's start with our incidents. As you can see, I have some over here. If it's loading, here we are. Let's go over to this iCard test cell detected on one endpoint, which is quite a simple testing incident. I've downloaded a iCard test cell and that generated a incident. So, and what we see when we have opened our incident, here on the right side of the screen, we have an incident summary, which I think is really nice, especially if you're dealing with a really big incident that will get you up to speed quite fast. In this case, it's just two alerts, so not a complicated incident. But if it's a complex incident, the analyst can read over here what the incident is about, and it will get him up to speed quite quickly. I like that. Another thing that we see over here is the guided response. These are suggested steps by Microsoft that an analyst could take to investigate and respond on an incident. In my case, I have an investigation recommendation, which is actually contacting the user through Teams and let them confirm their activity. So this incident is about downloading a iCard file, which is a test file to test all kinds of EDR solutions. I could use this message over here. I actually can copy this to my clipboard, put it in a Teams message to this user, and wait for the user to respond. And there is already stated in this message that it's okay for the user to answer yes, no, or don't know. So that can help us quickly resolve this this incident. As a security lover by heart, I would actually recommend calling this user and let him enable his webcam so we know that it's the real user that we are dealing with. Just chatting with this user could also end up the attacker responding to us with, yes, this is expected behavior. So keep that in mind when dealing with this kind of recommendations. So I can copy this to my clipboard, ask this to the user. So this is quite nice. So what's good for you to know that every time when we refresh this page, so a full refresh of my browser, it will generate these responses again. If I stay using this session, so let's say I switch to home, I go back to my incident, navigate back to it, Let's wait for it. You'll see it loaded quite quickly. So the response was cached in my browser session. It's not generated again. If you refresh this a lot, it will cost you compute. So if we look over here in the securitycopilot.microsoft.com, if you go to usage monitoring, you will get on this page and you will see what your current usage of Copilot for Security is. So just as with the standalone experience, the embedded experience also cost you compute. So be careful with how much you are going to refresh the incident page, because it will generate a new summary and a new investigation, and that will cost you a compute on your Microsoft Copilot for Security compute capacity. So keep that in mind. So here you saw the real power of Copilot for Security. I like the embedded experience a lot. The summary is great for dealing with big incidents, and with the unification of Microsoft Sentinel and Defender for Endpoint, a lot more is correlated to the same incident. So I think this is a perfect addition to get up to speed for your analysts quickly. I also like the guided response, which suggested me to contact my user through Teams. I like this these suggestions of Copilot in the embedded experience. So let's now switch over to the advanced hunting capabilities of Microsoft XDR and see what experience Copilot for Security can bring us over there. But not before we have created a perfect cup of coffee. There's no Azure vlog with coffee, right? See you in a minute. That was a very lovely cup of coffee. So let's now switch gears and dive into the advanced hunting capabilities of Microsoft XDR. And let's see what Copilot for Security can bring us over there. So let's switch over to my desktop. I'm here in the Microsoft XDR portal. And if we go in the menu to advanced hunting, that will bring us to the page where we can write our queries, see all the tables and stuff. And I've already opened up a query over here. If I run this, you'll see it's working. And let's see if we can filter in this query by severity using Copilot. Could you make sure only incidents with severity low are displayed? I will push that into Copilot. Copilot will generate the response for us. Let's wait for it to complete. And here it responded back to us with a DKQL query. I can run this. We'll put it in my screen over here. And as you can see, this query works perfectly. I could now ask it to only show the closed incidents. Could you filter on closed incidents only? We'll now generate a new response. Okay, this is actually not the response that that I wanted. I actually wanted a KQL that filters on my low severity incidents that are closed. So let's tell that to Copilot. I want all incidents that are closed and have a low severity. And let's submit this question, this prompt. Okay, let's see what it has generated. And this is actually what I wanted. So now I can run this query. And this will give me all the low incidents that are closed, which I think is really nice. I like this way of generating my KQL queries a lot, especially for the junior cybersecurity analysts. I think this is a great experience to learn KQL. You can type in your question using human language, and Copilot for Security is able to generate the KQL for us. There is also a button to directly execute the KQL. I think this is much more powerful than just asking for a KQL query in the standalone experience, because you are missing the whole results panel and stuff. I think the embedded experience here is way better than standalone. Hey, and did you know that we can exactly see what the prompts were from the embedded experience? Let's switch over to my desktop. I'm here in the Copilot for Security standalone experience. And what you see actually over here are the Copilot sessions. Just as with the standalone experience, the Copilot for Security embedded experience uses sessions. And I can click on some, for example, this one. This was actually the incident summary. You can see the prompt over here, and we can see the response over here. I think this is pretty cool that this is visible to us. So we can exactly see what happened and why did it take sometimes so long to get our summary displayed. If you look over here, it was actually a full round trip from Copilot to a plugin, processing our request, preparing the response, etc. So we can see that over here. And with that, I've showed you the embedded experience of Copilot for Security in the Microsoft XDR portal. You saw how Copilot can help you with summarizing your incident and help you with guided response, doing you suggestions on how to resolve this incident. And we had a look at the advanced hunting capabilities where we could leverage Copilot for Security in such a way that it was perfectly able for us to generate some KQLs. With that, I hope you like this video. If so, please hit the thumbs up button. Of course, subscribe to this channel, and I hope to see you in one of my next videos. Bye!